presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
Look what I got, right behind me here. Part of the Montreal River, west of Kirkland Lake in Northern Ontario. In Northeastern Ontario, this is what it's all about right here. First thing in the morning, opportunity to catch fish. We came up here to this place called Horseshoe Island Camp. And it's right, like it says, on an island. Boat's ready to go, rods are all ready, and I just want to get out there and embrace the whole deal. Because that's the thing about fishing up here in Northern Ontario. It's the lodge experience. The whole deal, you know, golf at all. The fishing is fantastic, camaraderie, making meals. There's no noises up here, no planes, trains, nothing, man. Just you and the fish. So I'm gonna just decide where I wanna fish first. Will it be that way, that way, that way, or who knows? Check out some walleyes, smallmouth, pike. It's all here waiting for you. I'm gonna get in the boat, start her up. Whatever my gut tells me where I wanna go, that's where I'll go. Well, I'm officially fishing. And you know what? I'm gonna take advantage of this calm morning. Remember I said this is a river system, right? So the walking bait right there. That little bait is gonna find me some fish. That thing right there. Walk it, toss it so they can chase it around and stuff. I will use the stationary popper, splish and splash it and stuff, but this thing right here should find me some fish on a calm morning in mid-July. Let's see. There we go. There's the dark smallmouth we're looking for right there. Huh? He's got three buddies with him too. Three buddies sitting out on the sandbar. See how black he was? See, that's what they do when they're feeding on sandbars right there. That's what they do right there. They just eat your bait right up. But when you see them busting, as soon as you get to a sandbar or weed, you know you made the right choice. Not a big fish, but I am gonna start culling up. That's what I'm gonna do. I came out last night. I seen a sandbar with weed and stuff. The lodge owner says, yeah, some guys fish with walleyes and stuff there, but I know that northern smallmouth love that kind of stuff. What I did last night, I drove out with the lodge owner, got an idea where people are catching fish, but I just wanted to see the different things. He showed me a sandbar with some weeds, some different points. So we drove up the top, the north end, about 6-7 miles, and just got an idea of what I'm gonna be faced with today, and where I might wanna fish, where I wanna start, and where I'll just put my hat down throughout the day and just work. So I got those weed beds with the sandbars close to deep water that I think that's gonna be my majority of fishing with the high sun. Now he hooked up. Now he's hooked up. About the same size, about the same size. But fun. Hey, how can you beat that, man? How can you beat it? Look at that. Hey, how can you beat it? Look how brown these fish are. Hey, you thought you're eating some bait fish, didn't you? Huh? You thought it's bait fish time. You know it's morning and it's bait fish time, huh? Easy now, easy, easy, easy. But look how chocolatey brown. You got attitude, but I need to find your 4 or 5 pound cousins. Mother Nature gives you those conditions that, okay, you want to fish topwater? I'll add a little ripple. Perfect. The camera will have a good look at my bait. Cover water. Walking bait, popper, keep going. Take advantage of that morning bite. It is only, well, 9 in the morning still, so I still got lots of time, you know? But just keep finding fish, move around. Don't get stuck on one little thing. Topwaters, we'll find them, and hopefully catch you some good ones. Section of the Montreal River on this Horseshoe Island camp has 12 miles of sections, rivers, points, current breaks. Remember, it's a river system, so fish move. They always replenish. There's bait fish moving, and those fish fight like the devil.
something about river fish. I don't know what it is. Even if it's a lake atmosphere, they've got current. They fight like crazy. So there's always options here. Spinner bait, jerk bait, love the topwater, and your soft plastics, and you're set to go.
Like, they don't even care the trolling motor's there. They just want to eat. There's a gang of them. It seems like those bigger ones were in that deeper water. 6 feet down. Oh, we got a big hook in there with the other ones. We got a big hook with the other ones. That's it. Stay down. Stay down. How big are you? Wow. Can't get over this, man. This is so much fun. Catching smallies one after another after an early barbecue dinner at the lodge. Look at them, man. It's just, it's cool. Watching the sonar, seeing them, and then having fun. Look how gorgeous these fish are. Look at them. Hey. Swing them, girl. Wow, hey. Solids. These are solids, man. Look at them. Wow. And they're sitting in five, six feet of water, man. They want to go up on the shoal and feed. They wish it was calm so I could throw top water. Remember what I said? I'm gonna try to get five and cull out. This thing here, right here, destroyed a lot of fish here. It is the 610 Legend X drop shot half shell, only about, oh, maybe 10 inches to 12 inches off the bottom. Smooth reel, because man, oh man, those fish fought. In the evening bite, this was unreal. Seeing the fish on the Garmin, look down, drop it from 6 feet to 15 feet, one after another. That's crazy, man. How many bass are out here?
I can only imagine the morning, you get in the right timing.
It probably is psychotic here. Probably. Well, I'll tell you tomorrow morning, we'll find out. Oh, there's a nice one.
Just the same size, look. Wow, there's like five there too. Whoa, hey boys. Horseshoe Island Camp. Look at that, man. Catching bass all evening. That's our third fish in about 15 minutes. All nice chunky smallmouth. We might even get lucky. With the numbers like this, we might get lucky. We might get lucky and hook us a nice, fat, big one. Look at that penetration, eh? The drop shot. You see them on that sonar? Man, oh man. You just drop it straight down. Straight down. Nice little chocolates come up to eat. Go on. Bye. Oh my goodness me. Straight down, right here. Watch this. 5.5 feet of water, you say. There's no way. No way. Not in 6 feet. He's not going to hook one. Yeah, they're ready to come up to eat. They're ready to come up to eat. Look at them. Wow. No giants, but man, you cannot beat that kind of fun. Come to a lodge. Look at that, man. Seriously. It's so much fun, man. Like, I love catching big bass. Come on. Who doesn't? I do it everywhere. All over the places. All over Ontario, man. But when I can come out like this, at the lodge and have a great time and catching fish all around me, little chunks like that right below the boat. Is there any more? Watch this. Let's see. Oh boy, how many are here? Are they all want to feed and eat? It's loaded right here. Right here, it's loaded right below me right now. But I think my bait's off a bit. Nope. It's just crazy. It's just lunacy. Look, lunacy. That's what this is. They're in 6 feet of water. I'm on a gravel bar. That's all like 25, 30 feet of water. And they're coming up, getting ready to feed in the evening.
Oh, he's a bit better. Look at him. Wow. Hey, he's a bit better. He's a little bit better. Look at that one.
He's camera shy. Look.
Wow. How many smallmouth are out here? Hey, how many smallmouth are out here? Hope I don't catch them all, because I want to catch a bunch in the morning. How many are out here, my friend? I mean, that's three drops in a row. Look how chunky. Hey, gorgeous, gorgeous fish. Let's put them down right here, because I think if I rig my bait just right, push it back over the hook eye like that, they tang that up a little bit. Push it over. I just got that little drop shot, small little hook, little bait like that. It's all torn after catching four fish. Drop it straight down. Ready? Here we go. Right here? Right there? Will it happen again? Let's see. Let's see. Oh, there was a big hook right there, dude. Real big hook. Look at that. Whoa. Maybe one of those giants came in to feed. But that is what lodge fishing can be like, man. So much excitement. You get good ones in the morning on top, on trees. Then you come out in the evening, either for walleyes, pike, or just that non-stop fun. Lodge life, go fish in Ontario. You know why? Because it's catching. Oh boy, look at this right here. There's good ones right here, right here. Oh, we got it. I think he got my bait. Oh. Whoa. Whoa. Oh boy. Hey. They are on fire evenings here. Wow, I might have to stay longer. You can't tell me that's not exciting, man. Drop down, you see the fish on the sonar, and just pound them right there. Look at that. Think I could swing them? Think I could swing them? Oh! Go! Turn them, turn them. Whoa. Man, they are like wild dogs. Look. Look. Yeah. That's respectable, no matter where you fish. Look at. That's a nice bass right there, boy. Right through that hard cartilage. He's not coming off. There's no way. There's no way. I'm just like, I came out for some evening topwater and thinking, okay, I get some fish on top. Have some more fun. Like, look at that. Tell me that's not a gorgeous fish. Take some pictures of some fish. Look at that. Beautiful smallmouth bass. How chunky. All right. Second morning. Top water. And I'm in 27 feet of water. I got the side view. I got everything looking my old trails. So all I'm gonna do is put down to the sonar. I know where I'm going.
There's all bait fish. Let's see if there's any bass out in the deep water, suspended, eating bait. Look how nice this one casts. Once we get over, right there. It feels like a, oh, nice fish too.
Yeah. Is there some deep fish out here?
There are some deep fish out here. Wow. Just wow, man. What a fishery. I keep saying it. But I'm telling you, I wish I had a full week here. That's how much fun this place is. Wow, look how he ate it too. He meant it. Look at that. Nice little bass to start my day, huh? Oh yeah, look at that. There's nothing wrong with bass like that, boys. Look at that. He definitely wanted to eat that, huh? Oh yeah, he wanted to eat that. Here's my first one. Look how dark he is. Oh man, these fish are beautiful here. Beautiful. And this fish right here is phenomenal. I've been a lot of places, a lot of great spots in Ontario, but this here, it's in the top three probably for the amount of topwater bite availability, schools of fish, and locations where you can catch them. I'm just gonna keep going live because
I want to see another one, don't you? The streaks everywhere. 23 feet of water. You get schooling fish. It's like they chase it because they don't want another one to eat it. He feels good. Oh my goodness me. Oh. Wow, lordy, lordy. Whoa, back off, Carl. Let him have some drag. That's a better fish. Wow, hey. Just incredible, man. Really is. Look at him. Yeah, there's a net fish. Let's see if he comes in here. Come here, boy. Oh, yeah. Look at those bass, eh? Oh, yeah. See, that's why we use a net. Because look, he's not in the net now, is he? He's out. Definitely upgraded.
What do you think of that? Hey, Northern Ontario now? You convinced? Hook up your buddies, your wife, your friends, your brothers and sisters, because these big, beautiful fish are here for you.
Safety, take some pictures, and then we'll let them go. 27 feet of water. I'm nowhere near that gravel bar where I was catching fish the last day and a half. Nowhere near it. These are those vagabonds. Those big fish that feed in deep water. Those are the ones I like. And in the right conditions, you can catch them all day long on top. Probably even over 30, 40 feet of water. Don't think you always have to be at points and things like that. Because these are the big ones. Wow, ate it right at the boat. At the boat, man. Give him some drag. Not sure how big you are. Oh, it's not bad. He just came up slow and ate it right there. Look, he wants the shelter of the boat. Yeah, look at that. He likes the darkness of the boat, huh? Get out underneath there, huh? Get out of there. It's another nice fish. Look at that. Look how he ate it. He just inhaled it. Just inhaled it. Oh, man. These are gorgeous fish. Hold on, buddy. Hold on. I'll get you. Just seen him come up and eat it. And you can tell how he thinks it's real, man. How he's just coming up like this. Ooh. Not smashing on the side of it, trying to kill it, but coming up and eating it just like it's real. That's a good sign of a bait.
Escape to Horseshoe Island Camp on the beautiful Montreal River for your next housekeeping, fishing, or hunting vacation. Horseshoe Island Camp is a boat and facility that features 12 housekeeping cottages, all built right on the waterfront for a spectacular view of Minnetikan Lake. With over 100 miles of shoreline, these waters are filled with walleye, northern pike, and smallmouth bass. The housekeeping cottages will provide you with all the modern comforts and amenities of home in a wilderness setting that will make the stress of everyday life disappear in a matter of hours. This location was incredible. Non-stop smallmouth on topwaters with not another soul in sight.
Wow, what a morning. Morning. Oh, my goodness me. Morning of blasting bass. Oh. Gorgeous fish. Look at. Oh, he's a chunker too. Look at him. Look how dark they are here, eh? Come on.
So he's got one hook in the side. When you get a hook in the side, they usually just slack off. But I don't want to. Oh, there it goes.
You want to come in? Oh my goodness, look at these bass, eh? Look at these bass. Wow. Hold on. Hold on. Got him. Look at these bass. So many, and they're so thick. They're so gorgeous. That's number five, but I'm positive that I will upgrade from this. So this little fat football, dark chocolate, beautiful bass is going back. Ready? Ready? See ya disappear. Woof.
What an incredible fishery. Horseshoe Island Camp. They said they had great smallmouth, and I'm telling you, do they ever have good smallmouth? So many locations, and I hardly see any of the boats. The amount of smallmouth that I saw, hooked, caught, kissed, lost, countless. Think about Northern Ontario for your next vacation, right here in beautiful Canada, full of bass, walleye, pike, everything waiting for you. We'll see you next time.
Are you convinced now? Book your next awesome fishing vacation at Horseshoe Island Camp on the Montreal River by calling 705-565-2222 or visit them online at horseshoeislandcamp.com. Xtreme Angler has been presented by Ontario Canada in partnership with Destination Ontario, St. Croix Rods, Strike King Lure Company, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Gamma Fishing Lines, Power Pole. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.